How to get a footprint chart on TradingView. Step number one, you open TradingView. After that, you go here, type of a chart, so you can see bar style, and you can go down volume footprint. After that, you zoom in and you will see such beautiful footprints. Let's do settings. After that, you can press 2-3 times on any candle and you can see here such settings. First, here what you will see on those settings, it is first the most important, it is row size. It is a manual. Also, you can choose auto ATR. Here ATR, it is average true range and depends on volatility of a coin, it will automatically will choose what type of volume profile, my apology, footprint to use. You can see if you zoom out to see a footprint, you can do something like this. Honestly, it's not beautiful, hard to read. I personally use manual, but manual have one big disadvantage. You need a different manual footprint to each candle. On BTC spot market, you can do 2500 and it will look like this one. Of course, you will need to do a little bit zoom in to see exactly all entire data to see where most of the coins were traded. You can see here, for example, what type of data. Like here you can do 5000 and it would look like this one. Honestly, manual looks way better for me. What this numbers means, for example, 257. It means that at this price level in this candle were traded 257 coins. What additional settings do we have? Before I show to you, my friend, I have special offer for you. I prepared my PDF manual about my trading strategies that helps me make money by using footprint charts, clusters, and entire order flow tools. You can get it absolutely free by simply following me on my public Telegram channel. Link will be in description. When you push follow, after that my bot automatically send it to you. That's why do it right now, go and follow me. What additional numbers means? Display, you can see clusters here, profile. Highly advise you to use it as a profile. Why? Because when you use it as a profile, you can see where biggest volume traded, and visually for you it's understandable that, for example, here most of the volume were traded. It's really easier to analyze it. After that, what additionally we have, type total, it means all volumes that were traded inside. For example, delta, what delta means? Delta shows to you where biggest volume were bought or sold. It's like difference between market buy and market sell. And delta often can shows to you aggression, because for example, like here, significant negative delta. And after that, you can see this delta area became powerful resistance. Plus, if the significant delta appears at some bottom, often price could move into opposite direction. Additionally, you have delta. You have buy and sell. You can see both type of volume. You can see ladder and you can see total. Honestly, I love to use total and I love to use delta to analyze to see what's going on. After that, background, apply gradient to background. Also advise you, because it's visually will show to you, it's easier will be to see the biggest volume were traded. Seller background, buy background. Honestly, those volume I love, I don't like to move it. The next one, POC, and show summary info. POC, it is a level where biggest volume were traded inside of a candle. You can see, to understand by POC, you need total volume, and it will show to you this by this gray where biggest volume were traded. Value area, as you can see, it is between this black dots. Additionally, about this candle, you can see here, you can see a candle. You can see how this candle appeared. And honestly, I don't like to see a body of a candle, because it takes focus from the most important one, biggest volume were traded. That's why something like this, it is the best profile for me. If you need to change a color, you simply go and change your colors. Few words to you why I personally don't use footprint charts on TradingView, because I think it is awful compared to what we have in ATAS. In ATAS, it's so easy to zoom in to see entire volume traded. When you analyze a footprint chart, you additionally can have double footprint. For example, like here, I have volume plus I have significant delta. Additionally, in ATAS, you can add additional indicators on a footprint chart. For example, I can go down into all indicators and, for example, cluster search. For example, I can analyze delta minimum value of delta, for example, 200, and add to a chart, apply. And this tool will look for me where delta, where minus 200 contracts. Let's do 5 days. Let's do a bigger volume, like here. It can search for you areas where significant volume traded. Plus, you can go down and do alerts, and you can receive automatically alerts by significant volume traded, and you receive those alerts into your Telegram. That's why in terms of working with volume, I still would advise you to learn about ATAS, but if you're a beginner, TradingView, it's good for a start. Right now, I prepared for you my powerful crypto strategies that helps me make money on the crypto market. Highly advise you to watch it because it will be also profitable for you. Watch it right now.